amongst the land of the living. Somebody ought to praise God right now because you could have been. You should have been. Crowd sweeping in your grave. The penitent somebody said, honey, I'm glad in grace and mercy. Oh, where have the living folk in here?
I'm glad in grace and mercy.
Praise God with you or without you. Let me tell you why. Again, I'm not forcing you, but I just want you to understand where I'm coming from. The last 2 years or last 3 years, evidently, we didn't see each other because of the COVID virus. But in the midst of that, right at the end of it, I suffered with multiple strokes. Somebody can see the significance in that.
Yes, sir.
Let me repeat myself. I suffered with several strokes.
Yes, sir.
It got so intense. They had to rush me from my home in Georgia to the hospital. I didn't even know I was in the midst of having strokes. But my wife looked at me, and my baby son looked at me and saw where I was trying to get my words out. And he saw, literally saw my whole face twist.
Yeah.
there, Zay.
The only reason why I'm taking my time to tell you all this testimony, because my grandma always told me your testimony will help someone else. But let me take it a little further than this. I feel a praise in here. I said I feel a praise in here. Look at three people and say, don't believe what you hear. Think about what God already said. What God already said.
Wasn't my friend.
told me that Spanky retired, and he told me he retired. Everybody counted the disciples.
Ow, through. Man. They did.
They ain't gonna save no more.
They did.
But I thank God for the verbal prayer that the righteous.
Yes.
And I got discouraged because I asked Tron, my drummer, and my bass player, I said, what are we going to do? What are we going to do? Ain't nobody going to want to play for us. Somebody said, but God.
Thank you.
Since it's been 3 years, can I take my time and say it? Look at Brother Minnie, look at her watch. I see you almost set our eyes on where they can stand.
Thank you.
myself so far. I'm just a want to make y'all happy and satisfied, especially with me. Trump, this is what Hazel said.
What?
You know, I'm a little bit of two-faced. Yeah, hell, I ain't rehearsed that boy. Oh, you ain't gonna leave. I ain't leaving Milwaukee. Y'all talking about me? I got to rehearse that thing. She said just a little bit. What can you do? But so we'll wait to do that next year. We'll wait to do that next year. We'll wait to do that next year. And listen, I thank God. I thank God for God is giving me my provision. And what I needed to keep this journey going. And I'm just going to be truthful, because Spanky was one of the guys that I always looked on the next side of me. And always had the confidence that he was there. And I just believe it was the trick of the enemy. Because you know when the enemy, and when the devil wants you, he's going to aim at the head. And the head first. But I thank God that God made a way. How many of you can testify and agree with me that God will and he can make a way? When you can't see your way, he'll make a way. So I was zipping around like, what am I going to do? Because when I wanted to sing, and I told the fellas I wanted to sing in Augusta, Georgia, I realized in the midst of my routine, I lost all of my time. I didn't even know how to sing Shackles no more. And I didn't experience that until I was in front of thousands of people. And I got shame. What am I going to do? Frankie's not written. Lord, I can't sing this song the way I used to. It reminds me of a story. How do you know that if you really love the Lord and mean it from the bottom of your heart, he will make a way if you give him the sacrifice he wants? Y'all didn't hear that part. You got to learn how to sacrifice something.
You know it.
Remind me the story of Abraham. See, Abraham, I want you to make a sacrifice. There's always, the Lord always wants you to do something or sacrifice something that you hold on to the dearest.
That's right.
And that's just to show how much faith you have in God and himself.
Yeah.
I'm going somewhere. I said, Lord, what you want me to sacrifice? He said, I want you to sacrifice you.
You.
And give all of you to me.
Yeah.
I want you to walk the mountain.
Yes, sir.
Climb the mountain.
Yes.
And bring yourself to me.
Yeah.
I kept walking up the mountain. Kept walking up the mountain.
Yeah.
Said, Lord, I'm bringing my sacrifice. But you're going to bless me, man. Just when the Lord saw that my faith was anchored in him, God gave me another lead, Samuel.
Really?
This young man has been with Doc McKenzie, Jackson's Other Lambs, Spencer Taylor, and Harvey QC. And when nobody didn't know how, that I raised him from a little pup in Brooklyn, New York. I remember when he was that age, he wasn't thinking about it, didn't want to be no good. But let me tell you something, I don't care what you think your life is, if God has a purpose for you, am I talking to somebody? for this young man. And he told me, he said, bro, I can't be spanky. I said, I don't want you to be spanky. I want you to do the best you can. So I wanted him to be all right. If R.L. Bush was sent for you, would it be all right?
Yeah.
And listen, y'all tell me now, y'all tell me if he sounds good. If he don't do a good job, he know I'm going to give him 2 pieces of chicken to go home. But let me stop playing with him like that. He's not that serious now. I need that serious. I want you also to pray for this young man. He just lost his mother last week. He came straight here from burying his mother. And I said, Richard, all I want you to do is the best I can. Y'all give Brother Richard a great big old hand, and he gonna sing this song for you.
Thank you.
could be.
Without you, my love.
morning, you and your lady in there. And they said, what in the world are we doing hiring a lady with the side? But you show them why. Show them why.
Lord, I
thank you. Hallelujah.